myself a cup of tea. I looked out of the window. Well, by then I was so worn out I had to come and have a sit down. I've been here for 7 hours.
You must be exhausted.
Mm. Oh, have you been shopping?
No, I've been shopping.
It's funny.
I'm worn out. I've been shopping for 6 hours.
What have you bought then?
Nothing. Nothing at all. A complete waste of time.
Wicked, isn't it?
Wicked. It'll be worse when we join the common market.
That nice Mr. Heath would never allow that.
It's funny he never married.
He's a bachelor.
Ooh, that would explain it. Oh, dear me, all this chatting away wears me out.
Yes. I bet Mrs. Reginald Maudlin doesn't have to put up with all this drudgery, getting up at 5 in the morning, making a cup of tea, looking out of the window, chatting away.
No, it should all be done for her.
Yes, she'd have the whole day free for playing snooker.
She probably wouldn't go through all the drudgery of playing snooker day in, day out.
No, it should all be done for her. She wouldn't even have to lift a cue.
She probably doesn't even know where the billiard room is.
No, still, it's not as bad as the old days. Mrs. Stanley Baldwin used to have to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and go out and catch partridges with her bare hands.
Yes. And Mrs. William Pitt the Elder used to have to get up at 3 o'clock and go burying for truffles with the bridge of her nose.
Mrs. Beethoven used to have to get up at midnight to spur on the minor bird.
Lazy creatures, minor birds.
Yes, when Beethoven went deaf, the minor bird just used to mime.
Oh, what's happening?
It's all right, it's only a flashback.
Ooh.
You don't fool me, you stupid minor bird. I'm not deaf yet.
Just you wait. Oh, bugger.
Shut up.
Right in the wing.
Shut your beak. God in heaven, I never get any peace here.
Ludwig!
What?
Have you seen the sugar bowl?
No, I haven't seen that bloody sugar bowl.
You know the sugar bowl?
Sold the sugar bowl! I'm trying to finish this stinking tune! Driving me spare! So shut up!
Da-da-da-dum.
You're right. Oh, incidentally, why not call him Hamlet?
Hamlet, I like. Much better than David. Michelangelo, you can use David. I won't sue.
Thanks, but I've had a better idea. Oh, yes, dear.
Another son.
Oh, my Lord.
Composer, talk. I wouldn't wish it on my son. He's a sensitive boy already. I'd rather he was a sewage attendant or a rat catcher.
Aha! Rats at 42A Karpoplenstrasse. Hey, Mitzi, I gotta go to Potato Street.
Put your glasses on!
Depressed by rats, do mice get it down? Then why not visit Colin Mozart's rodent exterminating boutique? Rats extirpated, mice punished.
Those Torn Apart by Colin Mozart, Munich's leading furry animal liquidator.
Oh, thank goodness you've come. We're having a terrible time with them bleeding rats. I think they live in his stupid piano already.
Get out some bloody piano, you stupid furry fat-toothed gits!
Beethoven was rather glad when he went deaf.
So let's celebrate.